Hi everyone and welcome back. So let's start writing this GitHub Battle App. Okay, so we will be fetching the repository information and the user profile information from the GitHub APIs. So we'll start from the scratch. Okay, so what do we have is this simple page index.js. So we can add the routing here. We are using hashRouter, so we can import the other required things like route. Route or new link, because we will be also adding the links here in this our JSX. So what we can do first, let's identify our routes. Our routes will be, consider that our route will be one is overview component, and other components will be the battle component, which is actually doing the comparison between the users. So here exact, and the path will be forward slash, and component name will be component name. We can define the component name. So these are the routes we are going to have. First route, so three routes. Okay, another can be an overview, and then this can be a battle, or you can say compare, because we are comparing users. Now we can create our components in the component folder. Delete this and create, because it was having the old components. So in this component we can have one overview component and one battle component. Let's create two folders, and inside them we will split them. Overview, and you can say battle. Okay, in the overview component, what we can do is battle component we can create for now, just a placeholder. And here we can have overview component. Okay, coming back to our index.js, now we can import whatever we need. So we need actually two imports. One is a GitHub overview page and GitHub battle page. So this we are getting from overview page, and this we are getting from battle page. Okay, so when you are comparing it, I'm comparing a two different user. This is a GitHub overview page. Either you click on the home page, so it will launch GitHub overview page. So we are done with the basic routing. This is a root level routing, which is having three routes: overview and compare. By default, we will launch overview. Okay, now we also need to construct a header. Header is nothing but, okay, which will have a ul li, so we can have a new tag. Inside new tag, we can have this ul li tag. So by default, we are using active class name. So whenever this route is active, it will actually make this active class available here, and it will be highlighted. Otherwise, we have compare. href compare, this class active, new link, and we are using new link, which has the attribute active class name. So whenever this route become active, this active class gets added. Okay, and we are using hash routing. This JSX is wrapped inside a hash router. Okay, now moving to these components, GitHub overview page and GitHub battle page. Overview component is all about showing this kind of overview, where we can see all the information, like all the technologies. This is the overview page. So it is going to have a nested routing. Again, we will have some kind of routes, and when you click on all, it will display all this information. Okay, so what we can do is, in the overview component, there will be an index.js which will have all the routes. So this is my overview component. Here we can just import React, all the required things. Okay, and here we can say const overview component, I mean just a functional component. And here we will be returning the JSX. Okay, so it is again going to have the further routes. So we can create a switch block. And inside this, we can define the routes. Route can be overview technology component and all, because we are going to have a child component. I mean, child routes, nested routes, these are. So by default, it will land here, overview technology component, where you can show all the technologies, repositories, top repositories. Otherwise, if you are landing or to overview component, then it's the same component. And here, technology wise, if you wanted to just fetch the repositories, okay, we can just wrap it around fragment. And then inside this, we again need to have a UL li tag, which will just show all this information, right? So we can just have this simple one, UL li, which is overview component, JS, Ruby, Java, CSS, Python. These are again new links. So active class will get added. So we just need to import what we needed here, which is route. We are getting switch, route, switch, and new link. This we are getting from React Router DOM. Okay, this is clear. So now when you click on it, we are actually launching this component. Now this component, same component we are rendering, either it is overview, overview name. So it is actually route parameter. Okay, if the route parameter is getting passed, then we will fetch the repositories based on that technology, like JavaScript, Python, Java, or something else. So we will create overview component here, overview technology component. So we can create pages here, and inside that we can just create one component, overview technology. Okay, this is going to be a functional component. So I will just copy and paste few things, and then I will change the code. Here we don't need this and no routing. Okay, I will just change it to overview technology component. Okay, now what this component will do is, this component is the prime component which will fetch the data. Like this is that overview technology component. Okay, either you click on overview or any particular route, we are rendering the same component every time. Here the difference is, sometimes we will get a route parameter. If you are not getting it, it means you need to fetch the repositories for all technologies. Okay, now if we just go to overview technology, it's a functional component, so we can take the advantage of hooks. Hooks means we can use state, use effect. So first hook we are writing is getting all the repos, set repos. And here we can use state, initialize it with empty array. And we have another property which is loading, because we are making an API call and it will have a state, loading, set loading. And we can initialize initial with false. And whenever the component is getting launched, we are actually making an API call. So we can do that in the use effect hook. Or whenever the parameter, route parameter is getting changed, then also we are making an API call. So here we can say props.match. We are passing name as a route parameter here. This will keep changing. So whenever the name is getting changed, you need to fetch the new set of repositories for that technology. So here we are triggering that, and here I have returned the use effect hook. So I will make an API call here. API call is like, first of all, we need to get the params, what we received, I mean the name of route parameter which you have passed. So we can get it from the props.match. Param. Once we get this, we can actually make an API call. Before that, we can just decide value equal to, here we can decide if name is not equal to all, then just get the value get whatever we are getting. Otherwise, just consider the default technology is JavaScript, and then fetch repos and pass this value. I mean, this is just a generic check. If you're not fetching all the technologies, then do this. Otherwise, fetch for JavaScript only. Okay, here we can have fetch repositories method, which will take care of this. Const fetch repos. Here we will be passing the tag name, because here we are passing tag. Tag means JavaScript, Java or Python. Based on the tag only, we are making an API call. So it is a straightforward API call which we are going to make using Axios. So I will just put this and I will explain this. I already have a snippet ready. So it's a Axios get, this is the API, and here we are passing the technology tag. So technology tag we have to build something like this. If tag not equal to all, then put the language tag something like this. It's a programming language. For JavaScript, it will create a tag like this, and then it will fetch the top repositories. Now we have set repos, and set loading is now false, otherwise loading will be false, and we can set an error if there is any error coming. Okay, now in the render function, sorry, in the return, what we are going to return is, if we get const repos, then there can be a repo list item. This component we can build, which will actually accept the repos which we have received. So that is based on a particular case. Like if is loading is false, loading is false means API call has been triggered. Now we might be having some data. So in that case, repos component, let's change it to this. So if loading is false, we will return this. Otherwise, we'll return a spin container or something. So that this is a custom component we have. That's it. Okay, this is pretty much clear. Now this overview technology component is being triggered from all the tabs. Whenever you click on it, this name is getting changed, and this name we are capturing here. So overview technology component I will import here. And overview technology component, whenever the props.name is getting changed, I'm getting name, and I'm making this fetch repos call. Based on the tag, it is making API call and setting up the repositories. So if you click on to this API, this is in the code. I mean, I got this from the documentation. This URL we are getting hit, and we are getting the list. Okay. If the loading is false and we got the repositories, if loading is false, that means either we got the data or something. So then we can just render the repo list component and we can pass the repositories. If repositories are not there, then it will pass the empty array. Now we can actually create this repo list component. So here repo list .js. Okay, repo list component is a kind of same thing. Here we will just displaying the information of the repository data. So import react from const repo. It's a functional component. From the props we will be getting data, like here we will be getting the repos, and in this we can just return a loop const render repo. What we are getting is, we are already getting this repos from the props dot map. Here we can have two things, I and index. Okay, and we can actually return this JSX. This JSX is a simple one, which is just accessing this index This is setting up the key value pair, unique key, and then getting the data. So it would be i.honor.honor.html. This is index. Yeah, and finally what we are rendering from this, what we are returning is, we'll just return it inside a UL tag. It is render repo. That's it. So this is our child component. We are rendering the data. Okay, so this is clear. Now the another component which we are going to write is the battle component. Okay, so this component is the first one. How it is rendering is from index.js. You click onto it, either /, or overview page. You will go to GitHub overview component, and in the overview you will see these another nested tags, nested links, and whenever you click on any of the link, we are actually launching these components by default. Because the route name is /, so it will launch this overview technology component. Initially, when you are rendering it, this props.match.name will be empty. So first time it will trigger this. Okay, fetch values, tag will be empty. So if tag is not there, if tag is not equal to all, then we are passing that tag, otherwise empty, and based on that it will fetch the data. Okay, so here you can see, if name is not equal to null, not equal to all, then we are setting some value, so by default it will fetch some data. Or you can hard code it. If this props.match.params, the route parameter is not there, then always fetch the repositories for all string. Okay, if tag is not equal to all, means tag has some value, then just pass this. Okay, so this component is clear. Now we have another component, which is battle compare component. GitHub battle component is another same component. We'll just copy paste few things, and then we will build battle component. It doesn't have a routing anything. It just have a two text fields, and we are comparing both of them. So whatever you are typing, we are calculating that value, and we are just displaying that information. So it should be like pretty much straightforward. Here we will have user 1, user 2. You can have a two different state, and based on whatever you are typing in this text field, we will be just updating it. Okay, so we can write input text fields here. I'm using custom ANTD component, but here if you just wanted to write input type text, just for understanding, on change there will be some method. Value for this will be user 1. Similarly, we are going to have another text field. This will be user 2, and on change, so whenever data is getting changed, on change we will be triggering one method, which will be just fetch profile. Okay, here also fetch profile 1 or 2, just to make distinguish between both the calls. Fetch profile 1 and 2. Fetch profile 1 will make a API call to get the data for the first one, first text field, whatever you are entering there, and second will make an API call for second. Here we will be getting the values from the e.target.value. So we will just pass the event object. Const value is coming from event.target. From both the text fields we are getting it, and then if event.target is we got some value, then we will just make an API call here and here. What we are doing is we are making this API call, we are passing the value whatever you have entered, and set user 1, set user 2. For both the users we got the data, and we can make this API call not every time. If value is there and value.length is greater than 3, then only make an API call. because we are considering that GitHub username would be at least 3 character or more than 3 character. Okay, so this is how we are getting the data for user profile 1 and user profile 2. Set user 2 will update the data in the user 2, set user 1 will update the data in the user 1. Okay, so this is how we are getting it. I think we don't need to set this value because let's keep it free. So whatever you are typing, that will appear here. Now we just need to display the information also of user 1 and user 2. So that information can be displayed here. What we are going to display here is name, location, company, and maybe a repository name and followers. So we can just directly create a ready fragment. So this is for user 1. We are getting the name, company, and location. And similarly, we can also list down the repository list, user 1 dot public repo and followers, and followers we can also add. And then for same with the user 2, and based on that we can decide who is the winner. I mean, you can use any custom UI to just arrange this content in the left and right, and you can show. But this is the basic concept I wanted to show. This is how it will work. We are using just a use state hook, so we can import this. I used ANTD, or you can use React Bootstrap. All these are actually framework or React material to arrange your UI. So there are two text fields, on change, I'm making a call. Based on that, I'm fetching the information. So here you can have a submit button also. I mean, currently we are just making API call, doing on change, right? On change, we don't have submit button. You can create a form where you take the input of user 1, user 2, and click on submit button, then make an API call and show the information in left and right. Okay. So this is about this GitHub battle component. There are two root component and then there are nested components we have in this overview. And compare is a GitHub battle, which is comparing the information fetched from GitHub APIs for two different GitHub usernames. So in the next video, we'll just do a quickly wrap up on to the different components we have created.